Good afternoon. This is Al Kuritz. I am the Service and Applications Manager for Electron Microscopy Sciences, and today I will be showing you a brief overview of proper setup of the E3100 critical point dryer. All right, this is a display of all the items you should get in your accessory kit with your E3100 critical point dryer. This is the pressure hose, which allows you to transfer carbon dioxide from the tank to the critical point dryer. This is an associated fiber washer that goes with one end. US variety tanks will take this adapter, which screws into here. We'll get to that a little bit down the road. You have the thermometer temperature gauge, which will get inserted in the side of the critical point dryer. It's removed for shipping purposes. I'll show you how to do that shortly. It's quite simple. Some spare O-rings and valve seals that come with the system. A copper washer and a spare burst membrane in case you overpressurize the system and the safety device activates. How exciting. We have a spare Doughty seal for the back of the chamber. We have what is called the Tommy bar, which allows you to tighten the chamber closed so you get a good seal. And lastly, we have a length of hose that allows you to make connections with the critical point dryer outer jacket to a heating and cooling source of water. Some people in some locations can use tap water, but remember, the E3100 has a large mass and requires quite a bit of heating and cooling capacity to reach plus 40 and plus 5 degrees Celsius temperatures needed for optimal operation. We also offer various heating and cooling circulating pumps and chillers. Those items are in the catalog for your review. All right, here we are at the 3100. It's in a fume hood currently. I have the thermometer, which we just saw on the setup, and that inserts into this orifice here and gets pushed all the way in as far as it will go, and then this can remain right in front where you can monitor it. Some of the other items you need to know about on the E3100 is you have the pressure gauge, which shows you the pressure inside the critical point drying chamber. You have two valves on top. One is CO2 in, one is CO2 out, and then you have another valve down here at the bottom, which is the drain, which you let out the intermediate fluid, typically ethanol, so you can get that purged out of the chamber. All these valves are somewhat delicate. You want to open and close them without having to use any wrenches or items like that. They're very sensitive. If you just hand tighten them, they will give you a long life of use. Also, here and here is the water inlet for the jacket around the chamber, which does all the heating and cooling. So you would plumb water in one side and take it away on the second. On the rear of the CPD, we have the chamber door, which is quite heavy, And in the chamber door, you have the Doughty seal, which I showed you. You have a spare. This is the sealing surface. You want to always make sure that that's clean. The so-called Tommy bar fits through a hole, so you can tight and torque it down so it's closed properly for your process. This is the viewport on the E3100. It's where you look to judge fluid levels. Also, you can look and watch for the critical opalescence, which is described in the manual, which is the liquid to gas phase transition that you can sometimes visually see. Please do not take the glass apart or remove it. This is really an item that needs to be done by a factory trained engineer. It has a plexiglass safety cover. However, you have over 1,000 PSI in the chamber here, and it's being restrained by this view glass. So if you tamper with it and you do not put it back together correctly, or the glass is chipped, it could catastrophically fail. This is best left to a factory trained representative to service your CPD. Here's the CO2 tank that you obtained from your local gas distributor. It is a special type of tank with a siphon tube, or also known as a dip tube. Since you want to transfer liquid CO2 from the tank to the CPD, you need this special tank. Otherwise, when you open the valve, it's just taking gas from the top going down. The siphon tube goes all the way to the bottom of the tank and takes liquid CO2 and delivers it to the CPD. So you need a liquid CO2 with a dip tube. Once you have the tank, you remove the safety cap. Always make sure that you either have the tank tied down to something, an appropriate system that's safety approved. In this case, for our lab, we have a proper stand for it. So you take the brass fitting and screw it onto the tank. It's always useful to put Teflon pipe tape, and don't forget any additional washers or seals. There's a fiber washer inside there, a plastic Delrin, which makes a good seal against the valve surface. Then we will attach the end of this end of the hose to whichever inlet or outlet we wish. It really doesn't matter. I generally will use the front one, and you will need to spin the hose. And again, use Teflon pipe tape. Make sure that there is a washer inside. Use a wrench to tighten that down. This end of the hose now goes over to the CO2 cylinder. And again, make sure that you don't lose any of the fiber washers or copper washers. Apply some Teflon pipe tape, and then use the appropriate wrench to tighten down the fittings Once this is all done, you have the water hooked up to the system. You're ready for operation.